My mother searched for my father.
Someone attractive, smart, but not arrogant. Someone with compassion.
Someone like him?
She decided she wanted a smart kid, one who would go to college, because she didn't. She chose John and her baby instead. My mother grew up more fortunate than most. She had a pool and a maid, and college was all paid for. I was planned. I was planned from the conceivement location down to the temperature. It was June, it was 65, and it was on the roof. I was small, and I was loved. I grew up less fortunate than my mom, but definitely more fortunate than others. After abandoning the middle child, my sister, she grew up to be a drug addict, and clean now, sort of. But I could never be that. Middle sister dropped out of cosmetology school, and she chose Junkie Mike and her baby instead. So my parents weren't exactly thrilled when I came home one day and said I wanted to go to school for cosmetology.
You're going to Harvard, and you're going to be a doctor. You don't understand, Neil. You have opportunities that I never even dreamt of, and I am not going to let you waste
them. I've got to tell you what I feel.
You've been so worried.
What? Tell me what you feel.
Wait till they find out how much it costs.
Do you think it's trying to tell us something?
Was their failed dream worth it then? My mom was perfect. She helped my dad with his work. She cooked. She worked a job. And then she had me, her ticket. Once I popped out, everything changed. She would drink until my dad had to pick me up at the bar and then come back for her later. My dad would work late, and once I was old enough to use a microwave, I was an adult. Old enough to be home alone, old enough to sit at a window and wonder if mommy and daddy were in jail, or worse, dead. That was the norm for a while. Nothing grand could come out of a situation where an 8-year-old has to be an adult when there's 2 40-year-olds right there. The older I got, the worse it got, but by then I was used to it. So at 17, when my boyfriend started talking marriage, the once crazy idea seemed more ideal. I already was an adult in my parents' eyes. They even gave the blessing. So, 6 days after I turned 18, I was Mrs. Campbell, the only married student at Penwood High School. I wore my big fat rock to prom with pride. And 3 days after graduation, I moved to North Carolina to be with my Marine husband. There, I cooked, I worked, I made lunch, and walked our dog every morning.
My God, are we gonna be like our parents?
Not me. Ever.
I would be the best wife. And I was. I just didn't know how broken I was, or that I married a leech like my mom.
And you don't like me anyway.
You know, I have just as many feelings as you do, and it hurts just as much when somebody steps all over them.
God, you're so pathetic. Don't you ever, ever compare yourself to me, okay?
He was using me for the extra check from the military and as a 24/7 support system for his equally broken world. When I noticed that, I started to question everything. But when he wanted to have a baby, I pushed all that doubt away. Was I about to fall for the same trap as my dad? Almost.
I specifically asked you, did anything happen at that party? And what did you tell me? You said no.
I know.
I don't know what to believe right now.
When I tried to leave, he played victim and manipulated his 19-year-old wife to stay.
Wait.
What?
I don't know.
What
just
do
wait.
You want, Joel?
Just wait. I don't know. I want you to wait for just a while.
Okay.
Really?
I'm not a concept, Joel. I'm just a fucked up girl who's looking for my own peace of mind. I'm not perfect.
Eventually, I played his little reindeer games and got out of it 3 months later, but it opened my eyes.
Myself. Why do I and everyone I love
pick people who treat us like we're nothing.
People ask me if I regret it, to which I say no. I got to experience life in a light that exposed so many shitty psychologies. I started to understand my parents' marriage, and I did it. I proved to myself I wouldn't be like my mom. People ask me if I would
ever do this again.
No. Do
you know how much that shit costs and how many places I had to go to change my name? I don't hate marriage, though. Well, I mean, I do. Like, the idea of it is irrelevant now, but the stats are there. 50% make it and 50% divorce. You just don't know what's gonna happen, but that's just life's gamble.